at Excel Mathematics, Core Mathematics C2 from January 2012. Question 8. I've got a funny shape and I've got to show something about it. Now, I know what this question is before I even read everything else. This is going to come up. Don't know what the shape's going to be, but we're going to use some variables, we're going to differentiate, we're going to find a maximum, and we're going to prove it's a maximum. It always comes up, so be prepared for it. Let's look at it a bit more carefully. We've been told that the area of the flower bed is 4, so I'm going to be using that information, and I've been asked to show that y equals as follows. So I'm going to use the fact that the area is 4 meters per squared to show that y equals that. So remember, the only thing I know is that the area is 4. So I've got the area of this rectangle. That's quite easy. So the area equals xy. Now, I've got this other bit down here. And, of course, that's also going to be xy. So I'm going to add another xy on. However, then I've got this bit here. Okay, it's 1/4 of a circle. So it's plus 1/4 the area of a circle, which is pi r squared. And the radius in this case, you can see that's the radius, is x. So 1/4 pi x squared. Now, I know that's equal to 4, so I'm going to set that as 4 equals. That's clearly 2 lots of x, y, plus, and there I have, now I could simplify this a little bit, I could write it as pi upon 4 x squared. Now, what I'm going to do is take that to the other side. So I'm going to leave the 2xy where it is, and that equals the 4. And if I take the pi upon 4 x squared to the other side, that's what I have. And then all I need to do to get y is divide by 2x. So I'm going to have 4. I'm just going to do it separately at first, 4 divided by 2x, but I also have to have pi upon 4 x squared. Now, that's all divided by 2x. I sometimes think it's easier just to write at the end times 1 over. The pen goes funny at the wrong moment. 1 over 2x. That's the same as dividing by 2x. Now, I can see the 4 and the 2 cancel to make 2 over x. Over here, you can see that the x squared, the squared's going to cancel with that x. So it's going to leave me with pi x over 8. Now, to combine these fractions, I need to make the denominator the same. So I would obviously need to times the one on the right by x, and therefore times the top and the bottom by x. That would become x squared. And on the left, I would need to times it by the 8. So I'd need 8x on the bottom, so I'd need to times by 8 up there, which gives me the 16 they want. Then, of course, I can simply combine them. So the first one becomes 16 minus pi x squared all over 8x, which is what they wanted me to show them. Now, that was only a 3-mark question, and as soon as you actually considered the areas, you got a method mark, and in fact, that line there also gets you an accuracy mark. So, you know, really do set off with these questions. You often get most of the marks right at the start. It's just a B mark, in other words, just for writing down what we've got here. But it does say correct solution only because they've given you the answer, and you do need to have the working that leads to that. I've now got to show that the perimeter is as given. In fact, many of these questions don't give you that first part. They just combine A and B here to make 6 marks. But you use the information you've been given to get the variable we don't want. We don't want y. Notice there's no y in this. And then we substitute in. So what is the perimeter of this? Well, let's just go around. We can see that it's got 2 lots of x, so 2x. I'm just going to colour coordinates. So you can see I've got 4 lots of y, so plus 4 lots of y. And then finally, we've got 1/4 the perimeter of a circle. So 1/4, and you should know that the circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. And in this case, the radius is x, so 2 pi x. Now, as I said before, we're going to substitute in our value for y. So the algebra is going to get a little bit heavy. So hold on tight here. It's going to become 2x plus plus 4 times whatever y was. So I'm going to substitute that in from here. 16 minus pi x squared all over 8x. And then I've also got the, well, 2 over 4, that just becomes a half pi x. Okay. So we're going to multiply out this bracket to x. Now, effectively, the 4 and the 8 cancels just to leave a 2 on the bottom. So I've got plus, well, I've got 16 over 2x. And then I've got minus pi x squared over 2x. And then at the end here, I've still got the plus, well, that's pi x over 2. Okay. Now, notice the x squared, once again here, is going to cancel with the x. And then, of course, I've got minus pi x upon 2 plus pi x upon 2. So they both cancel out. And in fact, when you've done that, all that you're left with is the 2x there, and 16 over 2 is the same as 8 over x, which again is what they wanted me to show them. Only 3 marks, okay? The method mark for taking the perimeter, the accuracy mark for doing it correctly, and then of course the final accuracy mark. But they did give you, it was a show that question, so you need to make sure the working is clearly there. This is always there. Use calculus to find the minimum value of p. To find a minimum or a maximum, you are going to differentiate. Now, I can't differentiate it like that, so instead of 8 over x, I'll write 8x to the minus 1 plus 2x. I then differentiate it, so it's dp by dx equals, bring the power down, just show you all my working. You might do this a bit quicker, and take 1 away from the power, plus 2. Now, because we've got the minimum value, we let this equal 0. So we say 0 equals, well, that's minus 8, x to the minus 2, plus 2. I'm just going to bring the 8x across. So 8x to the minus 2 equals 2. Now, just remind you, why did we bother writing the x as x to the minus 1? We only did it to make it easier to differentiate. There's no reason for algebraically why we would leave it like that. And so what we do down here, we write this back as 8 over x squared equals 2. And this is really easy to solve because you multiply up by the x squared. You divide by the 2, so x squared equals 4. And therefore, of course, well, you could say x is equal to plus or minus 2, because they're the square roots of 4. But remember, x is the length of one side of a shape. So in this case, you can't have negative. So it's enough to say that x must equal 2. And I'm just going to sort of make a note to myself. I'm going to say, because x must be bigger than 0. X must be positive. Now, the question asked for the minimum value of p. I've found x. So there is more to this question. But that's always the first point you do. You differentiate, you let it equal 0, and you solve to find that. I've got a method mark for differentiating and an accuracy mark if I do it correctly. I've got a method mark for letting it equal 0. And I've got an accuracy mark for getting to this stage 2. So actually the last mark here is, you know, it is vital, every mark's vital, but you can see that I've got most of the marks just by doing this process. I need to obviously put 2 back in. So I'm going to do 8 divided by 2 plus 2 times 2. You can do it on your calculator, or you can do that pretty simple. It's 4 plus 4, which is 8. Now, notice how, because I've tried to fit this on the screen, my answer's got a bit lost. If that happens, make it really clear. But I would aim to put your answer at the bottom of your working. So make sure you leave room and you structure your work. Obviously, that last bit there was worth the final accuracy mark. The final part, for a very easy 2 marks, asks you to find the width of each rectangle when the perimeter is a minimum. So here's my rectangle. Obviously the width they're talking about is why. So you look around your page, because obviously I've been able to organise it myself, but you look around your page and you see a formula for y. So we've already said that x must be 2, so we simply substitute that in. 16 minus pi times 2 squared, all divided by 8 times 2. Okay, now the question says give your answer to the nearest centimetre. You could play around with this and tidy it up, or you could simply type it straight into your calculator. And when I do that, the answer I get to the nearest centimetre is 21 centimetres. Very easy, very quick. Make sure you get those final marks. In this case, a method mark for doing the substitution. And look how obvious it is, how clear it is that's what I've done. So even if I get this answer wrong, the examiner knows I've done the right thing and gives me the mark. A lot of marks for this question, 13. Don't make that unlucky for you. Hopefully you're going to do awesome. If you found this video useful, please do share it with people. Put it on your Facebook wall. People don't want to be looking at photos of you all the time, and they will really, really thank you if you give them any support and help for their maths exam. I also want to help you, so do get in touch via Twitter or Facebook to keep updated with what I'm doing and to request videos. This video was requested by Rahul, so hopefully he's going to do really well in his exams, and hopefully I can help you do well too. Good luck, guys.